In this example, we are given that in a stationary wave described by the equation 10 sine of 4 pi x by 5 sine of 10 pi t, we are required to find the phase difference of oscillations of two particles located at x equals to 1 centimeter and x equals to 2 centimeter. In this situation, the very first thing we can see that the equation which is given here is of the form which we already studied, it is y is a naught sine kx sine omega t. And if we compare the relations, we can see here antinode amplitude a naught is 10. The wave number, angular wave number k is 4 pi by 5, which can be written as 2 pi by lambda. So from here we get the value of lambda to be 2.5 centimeter, as we are given the values in centimeter, will take unit to be centimeter. The value of omega is 10 pi. Now in this situation, as the wavelength is given as 2.5 centimeter, we can draw the loops of stationary waves. In this situation, the loop length is 2.5 centimeter by 2. As we know, the length of each loop is lambda by 2. So here we can write loop length to be equals to 1.25 centimeter. Now as the equation is given as E naught sine kx sine omega t, that means the amplitude of medium particles which depends on the location is E naught sine kx. That means at x equals to 0, there must be a node. This is the point where x is 0. So we'll choose our coordinate system to be given as like this. This x axis, this y axis. And each loop is of length 1.25 centimeter. So the two particles at 1 centimeter and 2 centimeter, these are located at positions this and somewhere this. Say this will be located at a distance 1 centimeter and this also at a distance 1 centimeter. So we can see these two particles are located in neighboring loops, and we know well with the characteristics of a stationary wave that medium particles in adjoining loops oscillate in opposite phase. If it goes up, other one goes down. That means we can say these two particles oscillate in opposite phase, and opposite phase implies the phase difference will be pi radians. That will be the answer to this problem. If in a particular case two given particles are located in same loop, then we know well that all particles in a loop oscillate in same phase. In that case, phase difference can be taken as 0.